Hallo en welkom. This is Nina from Nina Hobby Site. This is Flossroom number 24 and I want to show you my cross stitch projects where I work on and I want to talk about it and a little bit about knitting and reading. But first I want to say thank you for all the new subscribers last week. I get them a lot after my whip parade. Thank you very much and thank you for all the great and kind comments. I really like them. And of course welcome if you are a return viewer. First I want to show you my favorite project, that is A Stitching Self by Amy Stewart from Heaven and Earth Design. And here is how it will look when it's finished, about many many years, but here it is. And here is how it will look, how it looks last time. It's a rainy and a stormy day and a little bit dark outside. So I hope I get good light. I try to make it a good lightning light, but I don't know if it works, but here we go. I did 980 stitches and I finished page 5, large format. And here is how it looks now. This is page 5. And I say it always and every time, I really love this project. And now you can see Sweet Life. I think not a lot changed on this project after the whip parade, but I don't know if everyone watched the whip parade. So my starting point was Flosstube 23 to now. So here it is. I'm almost on 4%. I'm now at 3% and 93%. The fabric that I use is 25 count, 1/1. And I did more than in total on this project, more than 28,000 stitches. So that sounds a lot, but it's almost 4%. It's not a lot, but I really like this. And I want to stitch more on this project, of course. And I think I'm now going further with page 6, this page. Because I really like to stitch in a square. So when I don't want to stitch on it, of I don't can see it any longer or something like that, I can frame only this part. And then it's also a good picture, I think. So I want to be in a frame, in a good but I really love this this project. I did in 2021 almost 9,000 stitches and I hope to do this year also almost 9,000 stitches. So I have to stitch more on this project. My next project is Modern Folk Embroidery Shawl. And here is how it will look when it's finished. And here is how it will look last time. It's the shawl from 2021. The Fruit of Plenty. Sorry, my notes is over there. So I look sometimes on the wrong side. Not in the camera. And here is how it will look now. And I'm a pink girl, dus I really love this. I stitch on, I hope I can show you this better. But I stitch on the big birds and a little bit on this and on this. I stitch on part 5. And there are 12 parts. So I'm not halfway, but I really love this. And I stitch almost 1200 stitches on this project. And the fabric that I use is 32 count Belfast Naturel from Zwijgaard. And the colors that I use is 3687 and 3685. And I stitch 2 threads over 2 blocks. Stitch 2 over 2. I did in 2021 16,500 stitches. And I hope I do it in 2022 again. But so far I'm 1200 stitches in My next project is Sunflower Cottage from Donna Kelsinger. Sorry, I have problems with pronouncing the name. Donna Kelsinger. And here is how it will look when it's finished. And here is how it will look last time. And yes, it was a dark day and I really need some color. Because in the Netherlands it's winter, but it feels like autumn. So I want to stitch on a color. And I did almost 500 stitches on this project. And here is how it will look now. Yes. I stitch on the sunflower on this part and a little bit over there, I think. And I really love these colors. The needle minder I made them by myself. And I stitch this one. The fabric is 18 count, 2 over 1. And I am almost on 7%, 7.5% on this project so far. Because it is the mini. I forget to say that this is mini from Heaven and Earth Design. And I stitch on this project in total 4200 stitches. And yes. Sorry, I closed my zippers. Some people don't like to hear the zippers. But it's... Yes, my next project is Quaker Floral Puzzle by Inkcirkels. Here is how it will look when it's finished. Another zipper. And this is a project with... I hate it and I love it. And here's how it will look last time. And I stitched so far 325 stitches. And I don't hate it, that is a big word. But I don't like to stitch on black fabric, especially it's 36 count. I found it hard to see it. But yes, I really like the results. I think the colors is amazing and I really love this. So I want to finish it one day and I sit every time a little bit on this project. And here is how it will look now. And yes, it's so colorful and it's really pop on the fabric. So I really love it. But it's always all... You stitch a color, a few stitches, and then another color, and then another color. And I stitch on a little bit on this flower. I really love flowers. And I stitch a little bit on that flower. And I think it's beautiful, but it's somehow hard to stitch. And yes, I lose my needle minder. My little girl, she's 2 years old. She always took my needle minder and sometimes it's broke. But it works, so it's okay. And yes, I did in 2021 500 stitches on this project. And of course, I want to stitch more on this project than in 2021. Because it's one of my oldest projects and... Yes, this year is my goal to stitch more on other projects, so I try. My next project is not this. Is Garden Kate by Amy Stewart. Here is how it will look when it's finished. And here is how it will look now. It's the regular format. And it's the regular colors. And it is by Heaven and Earth Design. I don't know if I say it. On that time I chose 16 count, the fabric is 16 count, 2 over 2. But nowadays I really like 18 count of 25 counts better. But I stitch on this project almost 400 stitches. And here is how it will look now. And I did the blue next to the birds. And I really like the colors of this project also. So happy and I can't wait to be there to get to see the spring and to see all the colors and Here's how it will look. I'm on this project on 3% and 3.16%. And I did in 2021 more than 2000 stitches. So I hope I do more this year than 2000 stitches. But I don't know. I really like this project. And my next project is Rozenkweker from Sticky Day and for Medium Perk. I hope I say it right. But here is how it will look when it's finished. And here is how it will look last time. And I stitched more than 630 stitches so far on 32 counts, 2 over 2. Belfast linen, and here is how it will look now. It's a big piece, so I'm going a little bit back, and I hope I can you can see it. I like the colors, it's pink and brown tints. I really love this project, but it's also an old project, older project. And last time. This time I stitched the letter B and the big motif, and I was starting on the next motif. And yes, maybe it was better to iron this, but you can hear the children, my husband is with them, but I have no time to iron other things than clothes, I think so. But I hope when it's finished I give it a good iron. But I really like this. It's also a lot of fun to stitch this project, because every time when you finish a letter or a motif, it feels like a little finish. And I think this was all my projects. So now we get over to plans. Sorry, I have to switch my notes. First, my non-fall coverage projects. I want to stitch a little bit more on the Kweker floral puzzle. That was the black one that I showed you last. And my Rozenkweker, that was with motifs. And a little bit on modern folk embroidery. And if I have time, I want this all for a long time. I have the Woodland Fairy. I showed this also in my Whip Parade. I finished the stitching and the back stitching and the metallics, but all that you need is the beading. And I hope I have I hope I do some beading for next time. I found my how do you call it, transparent thread, so I can do that, because it's time to finish this one. I really love her. I think she's beautiful. But when the beads is on, she is much beautifuler, because she have a lot of cups, caps and holes. And I have to do a lot of beading here and on the dress. So I want to start with the beading. For fur covers, I want to stitch more on the garden gate van Amy Stewart. That was the one with the red birds that I show you. And of course the stitching self, because I want to make more stitches than in 2021. And if I have a little bit of time, I want to stitch on Garden Walk by Sandra Cook. That's also a beautiful project. Here's a picture how that will look when it's finished. And then I have a little bit of haul. I have awesome haul, I think. There was a woman on Marktplaats. That is a Dutch eBay. And they sell meer bilias with beading. And very cheap, I think. And I show you what I got from her. I have the Queen of Peace. I like the bird and the gold in her dress. And I have also the beads and the specially threads. But I have more. That was an awesome woman. I have another Mirabilia. Very idle. I saw this on Luda channel. I forget her name. Luda, I think you know her. She stitched this one, and this is a beautiful big big project. But I think she is awesome. And I have also the beads and the specially thread. And then I have another. I really like this. It reminds me a little bit of my girl. So when she grow up, see. And I really love pink, so this is amazing. It also the beads, a little bit of beads to she needs. And 3 for T. I really like tea and pink, so this was beautiful. And I have to add it. And the last one, the Christmas elegance. I can't pronounce this. Elegance. Now you know it's beautiful. It's the Mirabilia number 6, and I really love her because I really like the how she look on this fabric. This maybe I have to get this fabric one day when I start her. But yes, I love her. I want to talk a little bit about my rotation. I have a 3-day rotation and it's not strict at all. But I want to knit and read more this year. So I have now a rotation with day 1 it's for coverage projects. And then I switch between 18 count or lower and then 25 count of higher. My next day I want to stitch on a non-for coverage project because I want to stitch more on them. I love the look of non-for coverage project, but to stitch for me it's comfortable and relaxed stitching is the for coverage project. So I try to stitch also more on my non-for coverage pieces because I buy them like Mirabilia's, but I stitch more on for coverage projects. And then my third day is to for other crafts and hobbies like reading, knitting or sewing or something like that. And yes, I try it for a month and for now it works. And I give all my hobbies a little bit of time. And next I want to talk about my knitting. First I want to show you my Dust of Snow wrap. And it's by Curious Handmade Ellen Stewart. Oh, somehow it's falling on the ground. And I'm almost on 43%, I think, on this project. Sorry, I have to get it. I hope I can show you this. It's with the advent calendar, the minis from a Dutch dyer, het wolbeest, with mohair silk from Drops, Naturel. And yes, it's absolutely my colors. I really like pastel. I have a pink coat. So I think that's perfect with my with these colors. It starts with pink, a little bit of gray and purples, and now it's green. Yes, I really love this. It's not a difficult project because it switches between rows with lace and then you have garter stitch. And I think it's very fluffy. I don't know if you can see it, and drapey, because it's on a 4.5 millimeter needle, so it's a little bit big for fingering weight yarn. Yes, and I really love this. And I hope next time to reach the 50% mark. And my other knitting project is, it was a call in October of November, I think, from Stephen West. It's the Charlography shawl. It's a mystery shawl and you stitch it all together. And everyone chose other colors. So it's really fun to see how other shells is looking. And here is my shell. The most of the yarn is from Draad en Kracht and Dutch dyer. And I really love the results. It's very pink, but I really like this. And I knit this right beds, and now I have to do, it's two colors, but I don't think you can see that it's two colors. And now I have to knit on the other side, also an beds. And I really love this. I really like to knit the shells for Stephen West because every time you have something else, and that's really what I like. Because the Dust of Snow Web, I like more the results, but sometimes it's a little bit boring to knit. And this is always so much fun to knit. It's different and you learn a lot. And yes, it's but I think the Dust of Snow Web I use a lot more than this project because this is a big, very big shell. Well, maybe I can use this also, but I think the Dust of Snow Web I use more because that is easier, effective, in efficient in use. But I like to knit this. This, yes, it's almost art. I really like this to knit. And I really like the colors. It's pink. And pink with a lot of colors. And purple, and very, very pink. it's in real life not so pink as on the screen. It's very neon pink, but it's darker. It's not so pink, but it's great pink. It's and I have the brown, but somehow my scissor was stuck. Oh, it's. I have sometimes problem with winding the yarn because my little girl, she's awesome, but she wants to help and then she turns too fast and then it's a little bit of mess, but it works, so it's okay and fine. The last thing that I have today is I was reading a book and I can recommend it. It was the first, I want to say it in Dutch, De Secte from Marietta Lindstein. In English, it's called Fog Island. And yes, it's about a secte. And yes, I think it's somehow interesting to read about it. And the writer herself was in an, how you call it, Saint Lordly, how do you call it? It's not a secte, but something like that. So it's interesting, but maybe you want to try this also. And I think that was it. That was all the stuff that I had today. And I want to say to you, thank you for watching. Happy stitching, of course. I want to go back to my stitching and I don't know what I want to stitch. Maybe I try to do some beading, but it's my other hobbies day. So I have to, I want to to work on my Dust of Snow Web. And take care, stay safe, and maybe you enjoy the Winter Olympics. I really like to see that. And happy weekend and happy stitching. Bye, thank you very much. Bye.